get out of here alive. A bunch of rapists and murderers. How do you like that, huh? Okay, time for the rest of you.
Who's out there?
I got a better plan. What do you think now, huh? Somebody shoots back. How do you like that? Okay. There's another one. I got you now, asshole. heard some.
Laying into him! I'm shot! Get the bastard! He killed him!
Okay, one left. That's the last of them. Guess your days of setting ambushes around here are over. All right, where did you hide your bunker, huh? I know you got one. Yes, here it is.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War, but living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. Man didn't know if his neighbor was an American who bled red, white, and blue, or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him, taught me the only way to be safe in dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. But we couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods, ways from the road, where no one would happen upon it. Bunker, you knew that if the country went to hell in a handbasket, you could open that manhole cover, climb down the ladder, and you'd be safe. With your radio and your hoard of food and ammo. Things haven't changed. Better to dig a bunker than an early grave. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, Cope? How'd that work out for the poor bastards who owned the one that I just cleared out? Huh? Not so good, I'm guessing, since they were all dead long before I ever got there. What's this? A map?